4 pounds of clay. And I'm working with Los Altos clay. I have not used it before, but it looks like it's a nice, it's gonna be a nice toasty brown stoneware. And remember if your bat is wobbling, because you're gonna wanna do this on a bat, fill those little gaps. And if that's not enough, we'll have to put a little clay underneath to get it to stick. Yeah, so we're going for approximately 8 inches wide. So something that's that wide, we want to make sure we're doing it on a bat. And after we get our clay centered, then we can start to lower it down. So I'm just using the side of my fist. Press it down.
So kind of like the plate.
Kind of like the plate. And I'm going to use the corner of my fist, kind of like I'm dropping a hole. Close to the 8-inch range, so I'm just gonna check. So this is about 8, yep. So
then, is that actually 8 inches?
Mine is, yeah. I put measurements on it, so I can just use it like a ruler. So I wanna check my bottom. I think I have a little bit more depth to go, but like everything, you want to check to make sure that you've got anywhere between that 3/8 of an inch to a quarter.
How many
inch.
Pounds is that?
4 pounds. So there, I've got about 3/8. That's good. That's going to prevent me from having to do a lot of trimming later. So I'm going to try to stay level with that and work my way all the way across now. Oops. And just like the plate, you want to go back and forth across the bottom to compress it. Check. Looks like I got a little bit higher here, so I just want to check to see exactly how much higher. Oh no, it's pretty close actually. Okay, so and then I can start to pull my wall up. Now I think I'm a little over 8 inches. But with about 4 pounds, you should be able to get something that's about 8 inches wide by about 3 to 4 inches high. And now our casserole has to have a lid. So we want to make a little seat for it. You can do that split rim like I showed you when we did jars, or you can kind of do a little ledge that flares out that catches the lid. I and that's what I'm going to do on this one. So I'm going to compress this rim, and it doesn't quite feel level, so I'm going to cut it. Go back and compress that. Okay. I'm going to do just a little bit of shaping. I'm going to push it out slightly and then curve it back in. And to make the spot for the lid, I'm just going to flare this out. And make like a little groove in here. So I'm just going back and shaping, pushing this out. Okay, so now we're going to take our calipers and we're going to get a measurement. So our lid's going to sit in this little edge. So I'm going to take my calipers and measure that. Mark this measurement in your notebook so you can make your lid any other day that you need to. And that's gonna be that. And then I'll show you the lid.